Sip, swirl, spit, and tweet. That's what we're talking about. We're going to be sampling some amazing wines and meeting some new people at next week's Vino Tweetup. And to explain it all, we are joined by some wonderful people who are going to tell us all about this. We've got David Cole from James David Cellars. We've got Makiko Yamashita with Ready Wines. And then Julian Slee with Moss Wines joining us. All right, guys, a Vino Tweetup. You're combining two of my favorite things these days.
Absolutely. Wine and Twitter together. And so we are all getting together down at El Wine Lounge in Sacramento, and we're going to have six different wines to choose from. And actually, they'll get a taste of all of them when they come next Tuesday. And there'll be some food, and it starts at 5 o'clock at El Wine Lounge downtown in Sacramento.
All right, Julian, let's pretend it's Tuesday. I hand you a glass of wine. You're going to sip.
Oh, really?
And then what's going to happen? Give us a demonstration of how this would work.
Well, we always like to swirl the glass a little bit to release some of the flavors, have a bit of a smell. And 7 o'clock in the morning, I don't know where they drink wine. We do it in TV land and most of Europe,
Well, I'll
I
tell
guess.
You what. It's late enough in Australia, so let's pretend you're back home in Melbourne right now.
Delicious. I think I'll have some more.
Okay. So now that you've sampled, you would then pick up your phone and you would tweet about it. And what would you tweet about what you just sampled?
Well, I'd probably take a photo of it and I'd describe the wine and say something great about it, where I bought it, what it tasted like, and people that are following me on Twitter would catch on to that and maybe go and purchase that wine themselves.
Very fun. So, Makiko, how is this good for the vintners?
How is it good?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's nice that people recognize, and it's a nice way that to get the words out.
And a fun way.
Yeah, it's a fun.
You know, building on something.
And it's more personal.
And it's more personal, and it's also, David, very trendy, too.
It is very trendy. I think wine and the internet go well together. You know, if you're sitting at home and you're having a little glass and you start looking around, I mean, there's a lot of these things really starting to take fashion. You don't have to just go somewhere to drink and have great wine and talk and socialize with your friends. You do it from home.
Isn't Twitter just stupid fun?
Yeah, it's addicting, actually.
It is.
Yeah.
All right, so tell us what you would tweet about this glass.
Well, this is a Merlot that we make in California, so I'm probably a bit biased about it because
just
it's our own wine. Just a little bit biased.
Be biased in 140 characters or less. Tell me exactly what you would tweet.
I would tweet about this one. I would say a super smooth California Merlot, low in acid, really easy drinking, great summer drinking.
Okay, that's way more than 140 characters. David, we've got your Twitter page coming up here. Tell us a little bit about what you've gained from having a Twitter page.
Besides just followers, I've sold a lot of wine and met a ton of people. You know, I've been involved. I was involved in one on the Central Coast on Tuesday. So really a lot of people who have tried my wine, brand exposure, and just have gotten to meet some great people. Julie and I have been together before.
It's free. That's the thing that I'm always boggled by. It's amazing.
You can't beat that.
Sacramento's Vino Tweetup is going on Tuesday, July 28th. It starts at 5 p.m. It goes till 7 p.m. at the El Wine Lounge, a wonderful spot. For event tickets, just go to our website. It's kcre.com/morningnews. Thank you so much.
Excellent.
We appreciate it.
Thank you.